Kingsley on Buck Life.
He's struggling. He is struggling.
Is it time for Triple B?
Triple B? You mean Quad B?
No. The team's already decided. It's Triple B.
Triple B flows better. Okay. Why don't you go talk to him, see what he says. We might have to call in the big hitter. Okay?
Okay. So what's going on? You haven't seen any deer? Or?
You know, I just haven't seen anything. I'm struggling. Give me one more chance, Coach. One more chance. I got this. I think I can get a bag of deer. Give me one more chance.
All right, well, we got to figure this out. So.
Okay. All right, I'm good. One more. All right, I got this, Coach. I'll make you proud. What did he say?
He said he's got one more in.
One more? You trust him?
Yeah, we'll see.
Okay, here we go. Really? He's done.
Triple B, show us how it's done.
It's okay, guys. I got this. Watch and learn, Padawan.
I hunt one thing, and it's deer. White-tailed deer in Wisconsin. I hunt them preferably bow hunting. I also like to gun hunt, so I've been asked to show you my office. Please come aboard. So, if you come in here, first thing I want to show you is I save broadheads that I shoot deer with. So I have shot deer with each of these broadheads, and I've gone through a transition. I've gone through fixed blades. I've gone through mechanicals. I've gone through hybrids. But I think I'm going to go with the Montech G5s this year. So after showing you that, I want to show you what I inherited. These are all spear and arrow points that are inherited from my wife's grandfather. Each of these goes anywhere between 2,000 to 15,000 years. Pretty impressive. I shoot a Matthews switchback, the 100 grain arrow. I'm supposed to show you that as well. Now, switchbacks came out in 2005. I see no reason to replace my switchback. It is an awesome bow. I have a Trophy Ridge sight on it. I like the vertical sights compared to the horizontal sights, and it just seems to work out very well. Okay.
So,
now I picked orange and white fletching colors because basically I did that because I'm a Battlestar Galactica fan. There you go. I'm a dork. I started deer hunting when I was 12, gun hunting, and I picked up archery in 2000. My target arrows, which stand up better with the fletchings, and I have my, when I'm hunting arrows, with the blazer vanes. They just seem to be quicker.
So what's the difference? So you mentioned those, but what about these?
These are more durable. The turkey feather fletchings are more durable for when you're shooting target. The blazer vanes don't hold up as well as the fletchings during target practice.
What about the kind that light up?
Those are Luminox. I have a couple of Luminox sitting in here, my hunting arrows. I prefer the red Luminox that light up red, kind of like tracer rounds. That dates back to World War II when the American tracer rounds were red, why the Germans were green. So I'm not German at all. No offense.
Yeah, Doug and I are. So we got you.
Up top is my only Robin Hood. I am not a great target shot, but I do tend to hit deer.
So what do you mean Robin Hood?
Arrow within another arrow.
So when did you do that?
Ooh, I don't even remember. It's been a while. On top of that is my great-grandfather's 12-gauge from like 1890. These are old school broadheads, all right? You don't really see people using much of these nowadays. And old aluminum arrows I used to use.
And why did you switch?
The carbon arrows are lighter and faster, and I don't pull back a lot of poundage, so I like a faster arrow to make up for that.
And speaking of poundage, what's the poundage for your bow?
I shoot a very light poundage. I shoot about a 55-pound bow, but it's fast and it's light. That's why I shoot a lighter arrow. I like doing that so that my arrow doesn't drop at range. However, this is kind of a neat thing to look at. That is a before and after 12-gauge slug. This slug was taken out of a doe I shot.
So let's keep going on this shelf. Tell us about these original to the right.
Nice bucks I've shot. That was my favorite because that took like a day to find. And a couple. It's the case that that's my wife's bow.
So this was given to us by
our friends Jay and Nancy.
Yeah. Very cool. So something that while I don't hunt, it is an activity Kurt and I can do together. Right. Any closing remarks?
Save your broadheads are a great little bit of history. Of each buck and each doe that we shot. As I said, I was in a mechanical kick for a while, but the older I get, the more I appreciate just going back to the regular fixed blade broadheads. You don't have to worry about things open. You don't have to worry about speed of kinetic energy and what opens and what doesn't open. It just makes it simpler and more enjoyable for me.
Very good. You are awesome. And this wraps up everything for Buck Life with my husband. Thank you, Kurt.
You're welcome.